world today is on the path to destruction. This is the message given by God that when we see human beings today, we find that they are oblivious to the times in which we are living in. Let us start the study by prayer. Father God, thank you for your mercy, your love, your kindness. Father God, I pray that those listening might receive a blessing, that we might understand your word and put it in practice. Thank you for your word, the spirit of prophecy. Thank you for the health message. Thank you for the words of the pioneers, Father God. Thank you for the end-time truth of the 300th message. Thank you, Father God, for the righteousness by faith message you have given to A.T. Johnson Wagoner in 1888. Thank you, Father God, for the angels that keep us 24 hours a day. Thank you for the Holy Spirit that helps us to repent, that comforts us, and that teaches us all things. Thank you, Father God, that Jesus is interceding for us in the most holy place of the heavenly sanctuary. And thank you, Father God, that you provide for all our needs, and you care for us, and your love is beyond the love of a mother, of a father, of a husband. Father God, thank you that you that you said that Jesus will come soon, and it is a good pleasure to give us the kingdom. Help us to understand your word, provide for all our needs, financial, spiritual, physical, relational. Father God, I pray that you give us financial independence so we might have more free time and we might have this life abundantly of the which Jesus spoke about. In the name of Jesus, amen. When we talk to people today, we find out that something is going on the earth in 2018. Something which is not good. About 10 or 20 years ago, people were more in tune of what's happening in the world. They had more spiritual life and they were mindful that things are not on the right path. But today, and I call it the Obama spirit. The Obama spirit. Even though Donald Trump was elected, the Obama spirit lingers on. Millions of Americans who believed in Jesus now celebrate evolution and self-worship. And he continues on, even though this man is not in office anymore. And it's not only in America, but this word of self-worship, self-praise, self-aggrandizement, self-seeking is being spread all over the world. Not only the message of self-worship, but what we see today is that people are totally unmindful of their spiritual lives. The spirit of 2018, which has been growing in the last past few years, is that one makes their own reality, one makes their own belief, The spirit of today is that you don't need to seek for truth. You don't need truth. You need yourself. You need the present moment. You need your own experience. And if you believe in something, asking questions is not a good thing to do. Just believe in whatever you want to. Anything is truth, they say. And that if you believe something you cannot explain, then it's too hard to go deep into questions. It doesn't matter for them, because they believe there's no truth. Everyone makes their own truth, and the world is totally uncaring about spiritual matters, about eternal life. They care mostly about themselves. So the love for others has grown cold. He says in the New Testament, Paul says to Timothy, know that in the last days, men shall be lovers of themselves, proud, blasphemers, lovers of themselves. But love is a muscle, and it's something people need to practice for it to grow. If you don't daily practice love for others, then you will be selfish. There is no other way, either loving others or loving yourself. But once you love yourself so much, and once you don't practice loving others, the outcome will be that you will not be able to love others easily, because your love muscle will have grown dim, will have grown too weak to be able to do anything for others. And in fact, your love muscle can be so weak that it can become disgusting to help anybody. Your love muscle can become so feeble that you do not see no point in doing anything for others, because your person, your being, is all that matters. Your own opinion is all that matters. This is the spirit of 2018, something we didn't see before, and is growing stronger through the years. And it is rightly called the Obama spirit, because before Barack Obama, this did not exist. In America, most people were Christians. They believed that there was either truth, and if they were not, they knew they were in the wrong path. Since Obama, evil angels have been let loose all over the earth. And not only so, is that the people that believe so, they think they're in a new wave of happiness. They think they are in the cool trend of the day. This is the happy trend of the day, to believe in yourself only love yourself. Don't seek truth, but just believe what comes into your mind, your impressions, your thoughts, your feelings. This is your truth. Even though the Bible says that evil angels and the devil gives you thoughts and feelings all day long, it means that those people who trust only their feelings, their impressions, they are led by evil angels. Because the only truth, the only thing that can guide you is the Word of God, the Bible. The Bible is the only thing that can help you not to fall into lies, is to be led by the Word of God. This is the only thing in the universe, with the Holy Spirit and the angels guiding you, that can help you to be led on the right path. The New Testament says, save yourself from this untoward generation, from this wicked generation. But what the media is saying, what the world is saying, what the TV and all the press is saying is that this is the way to go. This is the cool way. This is the new thing to do. Because they believe in evolution. They believe the old traits of compassion, of love is done away. Our new generation now doesn't need that anymore. They have done away with the old traits of character. And now this is the new trend of the survival of the fittest. Survival of the fittest says this new generation has done away with things you don't need. And now they're into themselves. They're into self. They're into opinions. They're into their ideas, the thoughts, the feelings, their impressions. This is humanity, impressions. The mind. So what will happen on this earth for all these people? Jesus says in Matthew 24, beware, for the Son of Man cometh in the time when you think not. Jesus said that he's coming, and I think the world thinks about it the less. And now we see today, the most people don't think at all about the second coming here in Europe. They don't think about Jesus, about the end times. This topic is out of the mind the most it has been since the last 20 years. Maybe 5-10 years ago, people would think once in a while about maybe I'm on the wrong path, maybe I should be reading the Bible. Maybe I shouldn't find truth. Sometimes they will think about it. But it seems like now it is a cool trend not to think about it at all. It doesn't matter for them. They think that even if God exists, they believe they don't need to give any excuse for anything, any explanation for their behavior. But Matthew 24 says Jesus will come at the time that you think not. And when the flood came, it took them all away. It took them all away. No one escaped from the flood. Was there any group up in the mountain that could escape the flood? No. Was there groups inside cities that escaped the flood? No. Were there groups inside houses in the country that escaped the flood? No. When the flood came, it took them all away. So shall it be when the Son of Man cometh. When Jesus comes, every person that is not hid in Jesus Christ and who doesn't know God and Jesus will not make it, and they will be taken away, swept away by the second coming. The Bible says that when Jesus returns, he will kill the wicked by the brightness of his coming. God is holy and pure. Sin cannot exist in the presence of God. So it means that when Jesus appears on earth, those who have sinned in their lives will be instantly destroyed. Because the presence of the holiness of God destroys sin. And then the wicked will be dead for 1,000 years. The righteous living and those who have been in the grave since the times of Adam will be resurrected. They will spend 1,000 years in heaven. And there they will examine the books, and God will show to them why some family member, some friend, didn't make it to heaven. He will open to them the thoughts. He will open to them the words spoken. And he will open to them the deeds done in secret. Because we see, some life may appear righteous outwards. Someone can live day after day and they appear to be a good person. But God is not judging the outward appearance. He judges the motives. Someone can give $1 million to charity. But God knows the motives of the heart. He knows why this person is giving this. Maybe to be famous. Maybe to have other people give him money. Maybe for selfish motives. So God not only judges the deeds, he judges the reason why persons do things. It goes much deeper. This is why, I was reading yesterday in Desire of Ages, I think chapter 42 or 41. You know, Jesus says it's not too much the deeds that God judges, but the inside heart. What's between the two ears? In this mind, what happens here? This is what makes it to heaven or not to heaven. Because the daily thoughts we have, morning to night, is who we are. Thoughts create feelings, and the feelings create character. We become like what we think about. So the thoughts are very important. And people who don't guard the thought become wicked. People become wicked just the way by thinking evil continually. And we see that in Genesis 6 it says, God sent the flood because men's thoughts were evil continually. Continually evil. The Bible is not saying the deeds of men were evil continually, but the thoughts of men were evil continually. I mean, many people want to do evil things and they don't because of authority, because they kept from the outcome of the deeds. But inside, they think about evil all day long. Why? Well, there's no peace in thinking evil. The Bible says that we need to think pure thoughts. When you think about God and heaven, then we are attracted to Him. And you cannot have two thoughts at the same time, evil thoughts and good thoughts. So when you think good things, when you think things about to doing good to others, then you cannot think evil things at the same time. God brought the flood to them, to the antediluvians, because they were thinking evil continually. Genesis 6 says the earth was full of violence. So God brought the end of the flood. People were proud. People were trying to outshow each other. It says in the, you can read in the book Patriarchs and Prophets. God, his ear is stopped. That they were showing off to each other. And they were full of pride. They were thinking to themselves being better than God. They were worshipping men of the day. They say, really, Noah, if a flood is coming, why don't our great men, the great scientists of the day, don't talk about your so-called flood? The great scientists of the day, the learned men, don't talk about the flood. So we prefer to listen to these men who are educated than to you, a crazy guy who is speaking on the boat to this world and make people make fun of you every day. Really, Noah, if your flood was really coming, then the great men of the day, the leaders, the politicians, the scientists would talk about the flood. This is why we do not believe in the flood. This is one of the reasons why. And today we're living in the same epoch. People trust the learned men, the media, the great scientists, the leaders, the politicians. This is the voice of God for them. This is their conscience. And they trust this more than the Bible. But the Lord says, to find truth, we need to be honest. If we are honest, then we're going to find truth. We cannot find truth by looking what the world is doing. We cannot find truth by looking at the majority. We need to find truth by being honest and seeking. We make a deep search and then we find out what is truth. So the message today is that The world today is gone totally crazy, mad, totally mad, but he thinks he's in a good path. He's totally unmindful of the spiritual danger they're in. There's a big spiritual danger for the world. They're gonna be dying very soon. So now it's time for you to find the truth, me to find the truth, and to stay in this truth. No matter what the world is doing, most people are going astray. We need to stay on the path, stay the course. And Jesus loves you so much. Jesus wants you to be in heaven. Jesus cares for all your needs. Jesus cares for all what is happening in your life. And Jesus has solutions for you. Stay close to Him. Read the Bible, read Spirit of Prophecy. Feed yourself with the Word of God. And stay close to Jesus. What will keep you now? To make a study of the Word of God and Bible and Spirit of Prophecy, so you can feed yourself with the truth and be kept from the world. Father God, thank you for your kindness, your mercy. Thank you for your forgiveness. Thank you to love us. I pray, Father God, that this world might know the truth, Father God. Awaken them. May they see the danger they're in. They are so filled of self, Father God, that they do not realize that they're believing lies. Why, Father God, is the world not interested in spiritual things? Why, Father God, they do not care about truth? Please awaken them. May you show them that you love them so much. May they respond to that love. And may they be with you forever in heaven. In the name of Jesus. Amen.